Father, we thank you and we bless your name. We honor you because of your faith. We are very grateful even for a point and an opportunity to hear your word.
We ask you to prepare our minds and our hearts that are going to be receptive of your word and that is going to teach and transform us to better people that we are becoming. May you make us through and take us through the process of transformation. We are going to know your will, which is good, which is perfect, and which is pleasing. We pray for the condition of our minds and the status of our hearts. The Lord, as you speak your oracles in the hearts of men, you're going to transform our lives to the people that we should become. Get us to be attentive in every way. Do not allow us to sleep, O God, but help our minds to listen to you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Bwana asifiwe. Hallelujah. Hebu uliza neighbor, Sunday tulifunzwa aje? I want us you to have a minute, 1 minute with your neighbor. Muulize Sunday ilikuwa namna gani? Wewe ulisikia aje? Hebu talk to your neighbor. Ongelesha neighbor yako hapo. Muulize Sunday ilikuwa namna gani? Eh? Amesema aje? Atulifunzwa aje? Yes, Masi Kennedy. Your neighbor amesema aje? Ati hakuwa Sunday. Kama hakuwa umuupdate. Unajua ni updating. Hallelujah. So Sunday you are really taught. It was a continuation message of that our God is a God of instruction. And then he also touched on something that happened yesterday. By the way, jana kuna ubatizo uli happen. Na kuna watu walibatizwa. Bwana asifiwe. So probably my brother Karwenji, by the time atakuja kuita wageni, he can also celebrate such people. Bwana asifiwe. So Mchungaji, he touched on a message of baptism on Sunday. And it was very, very powerful. Because it was not just for the people ambao walikuwa na wanaenda ubatizo. Ilikuwa kwa kila mtu. Na mimi mwenyewe, I learned something about baptism. Ya kwamba there are types of baptism. Unajua kuna aina mingi za ubatizo. Na ubatizo wa maji ndiyo huwa unakuwa wa kuzaliwa upya, both with water and with the Holy Spirit. Kwa hivyo huwezi zaliwa tena kama hujazaliwa kwa tumbo ya maji. Tumbo ya maji iko wapi? Iko kwa mtoni. Bwana asifiwe. When you are immersed in that water, you are covered. And that's why it's called immersion. The Bible says immersion. Kwani narudia. Hallelujah. So today we are going to hear the word of God because our God is a God of instruction. Ni Mungu wa maagizo. Na kuna maagizo ambayo Mungu huwa anapeana. Kadri ya uwezo wa Mungu, ya kwamba tujue what does the word says. So we are going to open our Bibles. Na najua kila mtu wako na Biblia yake. Kama ni ya Kikuyu, kama ni ya Kiswahili, kama ni ya whatever language. Whatever you have, please open. And the question is, do you have the Bible? Ask your neighbor, uko na Biblia? Ebu muangalia kama uko nayo. Check your neighbor. Angalia kama neighbor uko na Bible. Tafadhali. Na mimi nasema kwanza mimi ama an encourager watu wachukue Biblia za simu. Unajua ni kwa nini? Nani anabebaga Biblia akienda kazi? My brother. Lori ya maziwa iko hapa na Biblia. Anasema, kwa kiwe anasema kikujo. Sindio? Unabeba kikujo. Unaibeba hapa. You cannot. You don't. But when you have your phone, you can, unaweza ona seme jina hapa. Na kwanza ya Biblia ni mzuri kwa sababu hata una post kwa status. Ile ingine unasoma na usomi. So, do all of us have a Bible? Who does not have a Bible by the show of hand? Either physical or not physical. Nani hana Biblia? Derek, you have a Bible? Where is it? It's charging. At Biblia, Derek, in a charge. Bible in a charge. That is, you guys should make sure in the morning, kama simu yako ina charge. Goja ilale kwa charge. Kwa sababu, that is the disadvantage. Kama simu yako ina moto, Biblia? Biblia ina moto. That is the problem. And that's why the Bible says we keep the word of God in our hearts and in our minds. Tukiweka neno la Mungu kwa kichwa na roho zetu, we will have the capacity to have that word every time. So do all of us have the Bible? Kila mtu ako nayo? Let me see my sisters. Jackie, you have your Bible? Very nice. Good. Mwenye hana Bible asongee kwa mwenye ako na Biblia. Kwa sababu ni mzuri, we will do good work. All right. Naomba tufungue Biblia kwa sababu kuna mahali tunataka kuanza ili tuteremke mzuri katika kitabu cha Yohana, in the book of John, chapter 1 and verse 12. Right, this is John chapter 1 verse 12. Not the book, not the epistle of John, but John chapter 1 and verse 12. This is what the Bible says. Inasema, I'm going to read mine. Inasema, but to all who believed in him and accepted him, he gave the right to become children of God. All of us, and to all who believed in him. But to all who believed in him and accepted him, he gave the right to become children of God. Si yako inasema hivyo? So, there is something that we need to understand. And I've not started engaging the main message of today. This is just the basis. I'll tell you the message as we go on. Inasema ya kwamba, wale wote ambao walimuamini na wakamkubali, walipewa the right kuitwa watoto wa Mungu. That is where it all starts. The Bible says how we become saved in the book of Romans chapter 10 verse 10. That it is with the heart that you believe. And with the confession of your mouth, you are now ushered to salvation. By the mouth, confirmation with your mouth. Na kukiri kwa kinywa chako, basi unafanyika kuwa mtoto wa Mungu. Bwana asifiwe. Now, what do you believe? Biblia inasema, ni nini hiyo una believe? Number one, you believe that Jesus died for your sin. That is one. Number two, you also believe ya kwamba alifufuka. Si ati alikufa na kaacho hapo. No. The belief also ni ya kwamba alifufuka kutoka kwa wafu na saa hii ameketi katika mkono wa kuume wa Mungu binguni. That is full salvation. And then now, after you are saved by believing, and then you declare with your mouth, the next step ni yenye mchungaji alisema, baptism. Ukaenda ukabatizwa, na ukafanyika mtoto wa Mungu. Lakini, there is a process of becoming. And the father and mothers that are in this place, I want you to take your child when they were very young. My mom, Mama Abi, take Mwas when he was very young. And then you see the process of becoming. The process of growing, the process of transformation. I want us to have that perspective because the title of our message today is how to become mature sons. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. How to become mature sons, stroke. Hapo unaweza sema stroke daughters of God. Kwa sababu yes, we were saved. Na Biblia inasema kwamba to all who believed in him and accepted him, they were given the right to become children of God. But more than children, there is more than just becoming a child of God. Hallelujah. Kale katoto, I guess he is the youngest. How old is your baby? 5 months. Do we have a younger baby than 5 months in this church? Makofi kwa ule mtoto mchanga sana huu kwa hii kanisa. Yes, we have the youngest, just 5 months. And there is a process of growing to become a son. And why am I bringing that? When we are saved, now we have become God's children. Romans chapter 8, we are still that, under that place. Romans chapter 8, ukifungua katika kitabu cha Warumi 8, 16, Biblia inasema hivi, Warumi 8, 16, all of us, for his Holy Spirit, for his Holy Spirit speaks to us deep in our hearts. And he tells us that we are God's children. Sunaona bado kuna dimension we have not touched. The Bible is laying a foundation of who we became. We became God's children. In general, kila mtu akona watoto hapa. The parents. In general. Nasema hawa ni watoto wangu. Lakini, ukiwachukua uanze kuwa analyze. Unasema huyu ameanza huyu, akakuja huyu, akakuja huyu, huu ndio wa mwisho. There is an analysis. But the word is, hawa ni watoto wangu. Bwana asifiwe. But now we want to go deeper and the Bible tells us ya kwamba the Holy Spirit, Roho Mtakatifu, testifies and speaks to our spirit. The Bible says he bears witness with our spirit that we are God's own children. Iyo si tafadhali, that one is cemented, iyo imemalizika. Wewe ni mtoto wa Mungu. Sema mimi, najua kwa uhakika. Roho Mtakatifu ananiambia. Na ninajua ya kwamba najua. Mimi ni mtoto wa Mungu. So we have established that all of us are children of God. Hiyo si tafadhali. Sisi ni watoto wa Mungu. Lakini hawa watoto, kuna dimension sasa tunaanza kuingia. Tunaanza kuwa analyze. Galatians chapter 3 verse 26. Wagalatia 3:26. Galatians 3 chapter 26. This is what the Bible says. Mine says, and all of us, I want us to understand this. So, hey, all of us, so, you are all the children of God through faith in Christ Jesus. You see, the Bible imetoa mali kwingi hapa na pale, and it is confirming ya kwamba sisi ni watoto wa Mungu. Ya kwamba we are all God's children through faith in Jesus Christ. Kwa sababu, how a child becomes to exist. Tunajua venye watoto huwa wanazaliwa. Mungu anawaumba kwa tumbo za mama zao. Alafu, in the opportune time, after 9 months, the process of formation, anazaliwa, anakuja dunia, anaanza kuishi, anakuwa, anakuwa kimwili, kimawazo. There is that process. So, we have become the children of God through faith in Jesus Christ. How you became a child? And to meenda back in the book of Romans, chapter 10, verse 10, the process of how you became a child of God. Uliamini ya kwamba Yesu Kristo. By the way, is there anyone here who is not saved? Nani akwaba na haja okoka? Kuje kwanza tumuombe ya okoke sahi, alafu tuendele na imaneno. Anyone in this tent who is not saved? Okay, all of us, we are saved in this tent. Anyone who is not saved here, don't fear. You come to Gombe, Wokoke, I love to Nelek, pick a gospel. Na hii hapa, anyone? All right, all of us are saved. We thank God. Clap to Jesus because we are saved. So, when you became saved, ulipewa title kwa kingdom ya binguni. Na hiyo title ni ya kwamba, huyu ni mtoto wangu. Who have been born not by flesh and blood. Because the Bible says that. Hatukuzaliwa na nyama na damu, but we were born by the Holy Spirit through faith. Wakati uliamini, na ndio unaona ni kuamini. Now faith is the evidence of things not seen, the substance. You now believe that now I have become a child of God. Hello? Are we together? Sisi wote ni watoto wa Mungu? So some of us who might have been doubting, am I a child of God? No. You cannot doubt because you are saved. And the moment you got saved, you automatically got a title in the kingdom of heaven as a child of God. So, salvation, at salvation, that point of salvation, you become a child of God. And then now, there is the whole thing with the baptism. And I thank God because nilikuwa nimeguzia na mchungaji alitufunza Sunday. Ya kwamba, this baptism comes, the first baptism is the baptism of the water. The second baptism is the baptism of the power of the Holy Ghost. And that's why you find out people have the evidence of even speaking in tongues because they are baptized into a deeper level. Yes, they are children of God. Hata nyinyi mnajua, kuna watoto mko nao nyumbani, parents. Huyu mtoto ukimpatia hesabu, anacharaza flat. Mwingine ukimpatia pale, iko shida kidogo. With numbers. Because the capacities are different. Bwana asifiwe. they have capacity which are different. Huyu kuna ile kazi unaweza mwambia fanya hii kazi. Na hii ingine, like now I normally go to our home pale. Naona Mwash anapewa kazi ambayo Ruth hawezi pewa. Why? Capacity. Hallelujah. But all of them are children of that man. So the third process, and that is where now our message is coming, it is called sonship. How to become a mature son. That is where we are. Sisi wote tuliokoka na tukakua watoto wa Mungu. Hiyo ni sawa, tunajua hivyo. But now, what about becoming sonship? And this is a whole process we want to read in the same Galatians, but now chapter 4. Hapo ndio sasa tuko, wa Galatia 4. Alright? And I'm going to read from verse 1 to verse 7. Tunataka kuangalia kitu hapo ndani, because there is something that is hidden there. This is Galatians chapter 4. Verse 1 inasema, think of it in this way. Angalia hii mambo kwa hii njia. Ya kwamba, kama baba amekufa, if a father dies and leaves great wealth, anaacha mali mingi na mali kubwa, ambayo it is for his young children. Unasikia children. There is a word children. Imerudiwa. Those children, they are not much better off than slave until they grow up. Hadi wakue na kimo. The Bible says, even though they actually own everything that their father had. Biblia sasa inatuambia, baba amekufa. Na akona mali, ameacha mali mingi. Na Biblia inasema kwamba, hata kama chochote ambacho kimeachwa na baba yao, ni yao. Lakini wale watoto, they are equal to the slaves. They are equal to the slaves. And most of you might not understand this terminology of slaves. There was a movie I was watching. Na kitambo hata sahi huwa inakuwa practice na huku uarabuni. Kuna watu wakona slaves kwa nyumba zao. You guys know that. Bwana sifiwe. Because maids, or they are called house managers. Those are not slaves. Those are house managers. But those days, when you had a slave alikuwa pure slave. Ungemcharaza, ukemwambia, ebu kuja hapa ni nasikia kukanyanga mtu, analala hapo, because they are slaves. Slaves hawakuwa na anything of their own. Slaves hawakuwa ata wana own anything, nothing, including their own body. That's why a master angeita a slave, kama ni kumchapa vita, amchape vita, na hakuna mtu atamuuliza. So this is how much to be a slave, how low is it to be a slave? Hakuna kitu unaoni. Hata ukikaa huko miaka ngapi, mnaona Abrahamu anaomba. Anaambia Mungu, kuna story tulikuwa tumeagree some years back. Na ukaniambia, ati mimi utanibariki na mtoto. But how comes now that I'm so old? He was lamenting kwa mali yake yote ambayo alikuwa nayo. Anaona, akauliza Mungu, sasa mwenye atanirithi, si ni huyu Eliaza ambayo sasa ni slave. Because slaves hawakuwa na capacity ya kuinherit. Bwana asifiwe. So anauliza Mungu, how comes that I don't have a son who is going to inherit whatever I have? Because slaves do not inherit, but sons inherit. Children do not inherit. Saa hii, ata mtoto wako, ule mwenye bado mkona yeye, mababa Mary, your last son, anza kusema baba nataka, hawezi mbatia. You cannot, because you know, this boy, when I give him, hakuna kitu atafanya. In the Bible gives a story. A man who had two sons. You guys know the story. The story of prodigal son. So the Bible says, a man had two sons. Alikuwa na wana wawili. Kuna ule mkubwa na ule mdogo. Uyu mdogo aka insist ya kwamba anataka mali ya baba yake. Kama ni saa hii, labda alithreaten baba yake na panga. So you guys know watu wanathreaten na panga. Anatoa panga. Baba anataka shamba. Hey, baba kiona atakatwa. Na hii Gen Z iombewe sana. Hallelujah. Hii Gen Z iombewe sana. Because sioni mtu mchua akitoa panga. Ati baba ni Gen Z. Yanaweza fanya hizo vituko. So akatoa hakutoa panga. But he insisted anataka mali ya baba yake. Okay. Baba yake si hadi hakujua. Alikuwa anataka kumuonyesha how immature he was to handle wealth. Akapewa. Na labda ilikuwa many gold bars. Hiyo si kwa kuwa na pesa. Labda alipewa gold because the measure of wealth those days was bars of gold. Kama hujaiona gold, enda Central Bank of Kenya. Wako nazo. Wambia nataka tu kuona gold venye inakaa. By the way, how many of us have ever seen gold? Real life, na hivi macho. Tunaona, kesho, kila mtu apande gari, aende pale. Tuende tuone gold bar. Hallelujah. So, akapewa urithi na baba yake. Akaenda in the land of far, far away, the Bible says. When he reached there, because of the level of immaturity, ambayo likuwa nayo, akaanza kuwaste whatever the father had given. Akaskunda proper. Akaiskunda proper. You know, and then he realized, Allah, ile mali yote nilipewa, because he was not a son, he was a child. Hallelujah. So, he said now, I guess hapa nime blunder. Na hivyo, hiyo ndiyo language ya Gen Z. Wanasema manze nime blunder. Hii ni ngori. Sasa nitafanya kimeniramba. He started saying, what will I do? The slave mentality. I want you to understand this. Hallelujah. The Bible says that he said in his own heart that I will go back to my father and tell him I am not worthy to be called his son. Why? Alitoka huko akiwa na slave mentality. Slave mentality cannot manage wealth. Slave mentality cannot handle the riches that God can give you. The slave mentality cannot even manage the position. Ka position kadogo, you cannot. So he said, I am going back to my father. Nimwambie anifanye kama one of his servants. Hata kama nitakuwa tu nikipata chakula ya kula, but at least nitakuwa nikilala mzuri. Why did he say I should go back not as a son, but as a slave? Because his mind was still a slave. Hallelujah. So he went back to the father. And ever said, now this one has now become a son. I'm in the process of learning. And it was very painful. Because the Bible says, this guy went to a process of lack. Alipata mahali kwenye aliajiliwa, kwa sababu pesa alikula yote. Gold akamisuse. Kazi yenye alienda kutafuta, the Bible says, alipata kazi ya kuchunga nguruwe. Kazi ya kuchunga nguruwe. Na akaandika kwa kazi, akaanza. Sasa haku anapoa chakula, ile chakula nguruwe ilikuwa inakula. I'm telling you, a whole son was eating chakula ya nguruwe. But he was eating because in his mind, he was not a son, he was a slave. Hallelujah. That is verse 1. Verse 2, inasema ya kwamba, they have to obey their guardians until they reach whatever age the father have set. Verse 3. And that's why, and in that way, it was with us before Christ came. We were slaves to the spiritual powers of this world. Verse 4. But when the right time came, God sent his son, who was born of a woman, subject to the law. To do what? To redeem and to free us from the slavery of the law. That is verse 5. So that he could adopt us as his own very children. Kwa hivyo, sometimes unaweza jiuliza, kwa nini mimi naomba hivi, najituma hapa na pale, nauliza Mungu anipe hii na hii, na bado sijapewa. The question is, are you a son or you are still a child? Ask your neighbor, are you a son or you are still a child? Sasa maneno iko wapi? Story iko hapo. Maneno imelai hapo. Watoto wote uko na wao. Unawaangalianga unaona huyu ni Wamboi, huyu ni Precious, huyu ni huyu. Okay. Hao wote ni watoto. But can I entrust this to them? Your heart tells you I cannot. Siwezi, because they have not matured. And that is the process that we are praying and we are trying to excavate. Ya kwamba, God to lead us in his way. Bwana asifiwe. Verse 6, nimesoma. Inasema, and because you Gentiles have become his children. Unaona inaturudisha kwenye tulitoka. We became children. God has now sent his spirit of his son into your hearts. And now you can call God your father. So, you see, this is it. This is now the revelation. Children operate with God, but sons deals with father. Hey, I have to repeat this. Lazima ingie. Children deals with God, but sons deals with father. That is it. Because it's a father who gives inheritance, not God. And a father comes from a process of, you know, relationship. One time, and you guys know this story. This is Elisha and Elijah. Who was the master above anyone? Elisha and Elijah. Ni nani alikuwa master ya mwingine? Elijah was a master to Elisha. So Elisha was a slave to Elijah. Na by the way, ukiona neighbor yako analala, mwambie hii maneno haiwezi kupita. Ah, hii haiwezi. Mwambie ulikuwa kesha wapi? Yes, Master Kennedy, you are doing good job. Unamtap, unamwambia you cannot miss this. Hallelujah. So Elisha was a slave to Elijah. One time, God akamuonyesha kitu. Akamwambia, huu jamaa, kuna vyenye, ninamchukua. But, he was to be tested if he has become a son. Akamwambia, naenda Jordan, wewe kaa huku. Akasema, there is no way. Mimi siwezi kaa huku, wewe ukienda Jordan, tunaenda na wewe. Akamwambia, okay. Lakini, akaona ni kama anajua kitu. Akamwambia, kuna siri nataka kukuambia, naenda. Mungu ananichukua. Lakini, unataka nikupe nini? Akasema, I want the double portion of your power. Elijah akamwambia, there is no problem. I will give you. But, when you will see me going, it's when I will give you. Alafu unaniambia ati wewe ukienda Jericho, mimi nikae hapa. There is no way. Hata kama ni kulala kwa nyumba moja, utafanya nini? Elijah started the process of growing to a son. So when the time of going came, wakati Elijah alikuwa sasa anachukuliwa na Mungu, walikuwa pamoja na Elisha, walikuwa wanatembea kwa njia. And the Bible says, go read your Bible. Sometimes I saw sasa tutakuwa tukiescavate sana, nataka tuna hint, mnaenda mnasoma. By doing that, mnashika. When they were walking along the way, there came whirlwind. Upepo ukavuma. And then chariots of fire came and separated them. Hapa katikati. Said walikuwa mbali. They were walking. But the chariots came and separated them. Huyu akawekwa huku na huyu akachukuliwa. Now, when Elisha saw that, something pulled in his spirit. This is not my master. This has to be my father. And he said, my father, my father. The moment he got the revelation that Elijah was more than his master, but his father. Ah, he got it. What happened? Elijah took a piece of his cloak, akararua na akamurushia. Because fathers give inheritance to sons. Hallelujah. Inheritance is not gotten from any other. Inheritance is gotten from father. And that is why the process of becoming all along, Elisha alikuwa anamfuata hivi kama slave. But the moment he got the revelation that this is more than my master, this is my father. He said, my father, my father. When he heard the word father, ndio alikata na akafanya nini? Na akamrushia. And when Elisha now got the mantle of inheritance from the father, he went to Jordan. Na unajua wakivuka, walikuwa wamevuka, wamepitia huko kwa tumawe. Akafika Jordan na yule Samo. This is a double portion of what my father has given me. Kaifanya, tia. Ah, maji. It had to separate because he's operating now in the capacity of a father. He's no longer a slave. This guy is operating as a father because mandate has been given to him. Hallelujah. So the process of becoming a son is what we need to understand. Because if God, by the way, let us open in the book of Matthew. Yeah, open Matthew, kindly. Open Matthew. Alright? This is very, very powerful. This is powerful. Matthew chapter 7, verse 11. Something has just loaded there. Matthew 7, verse 11. And this is what the Bible says. All of us, if you sinful people, all of us, please, if you sinful people, you know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more will your heavenly Father give good gifts to those who ask of him? So that is a question. Kama nyinyi, wazazi wa huku dunia, ambao some of you hamko sawa, in fact, the Bible say, you sinful people. Even we have seen huku kwa dunia. If Chris Kirubi, you see, alikuwa na mali mingi. He left them to their children. Anasema kama nyinyi baba wa huku duniani ambao sometimes hamko laini sawa. Sometimes you are sinful. Lakini mnapea watoto wenyu urithi. How much more is your heavenly father? You see, the Bible does not call him God. No. It calls him father. Baba wenyu wa binguni. How much more? Anatamani zaidi. Atakumpea mambo mingi. Lakini, the process of being given comes with responsibility. Tell your neighbor, the process of receiving requires responsibility. Yes, a father cannot just give mtoto unajua huyu nikimpatia kwanza ataniaibisha. Huyu nikimpatia. By the way, the prodigal father's son, wakati alisikia kweli mtoto wake labda analala kwa nguruwe, alikuwa anasikia mzuri ama vibaya? Mtoto wako umempatia shamba, ameenda ameuza, amegambo, amewekwa jela. Wewe utasikia aje? You will feel bad because he's not using what you give them in the right way. So the father who is our God cannot dare give you some things ambayo atajua huyu ataniaibisha. Let me let them be. Let them mature. And then after they mature, now they are able to handle what I will give them. Bwana asifiwe. Hallelujah. There is one quote I want you to write this. Zinaogopa. Hallelujah. Kama utaandika hii mahali uandike, kama utarecord voice urecord because this is very powerful. Inasema a child, all of us, a child is born of God. But a son is the one who is taught of God. No worry, we'll repeat so you'll write it. A child is born of God. But a son is taught of God. Hiyo inamaanisha kwamba mtoto anazaliwa na Mungu. Lakini a son. Son na Kiswahili ni nini? Mwana, good. Lakini mwana huwa anafunzwa na baba yake. Bwana asifiwe. So, a child is born of God. But a son is now taught of God. The quote haijaisha. A child has God's nature. Say, a child has God's nature. But a son has God's character. So you have to have a character of God for you now to become a full son. Are you guys getting this? Yes, so a son has God's character. But a child akona nature ya Mungu. We know we should walk in love. That we know. See, even we are created in the image of God. Perfect. But now what about the teaching? When it comes to teaching, are we walking in the teaching of God? So, the whole quote says that a child is born of God, but a son is the one taught of God. A child has God's nature, but a son has God's character. Because when we come to character, venye Mungu wako, lazima tuone baba abinda ni ya mwashi. Hallelujah. We have to see Mwash, the character of Baba Abi, Ndani, ya Mwash. That's now the character of the father. But when anafanya vituko, that is not the father. Because the father does not have such character. How can you deal with unforgiveness? How? Na labda yile mambo Mungu anataka akuweke, anaona huyu, if they are still dealing with unforgiveness, I cannot. And let me give you an example right from the Bible. Wakati ndugu za Yosufu walimuuza Misri. Na those guys were just jealous. Hakuna kitu Joseph alikuwa amefanya. They were just jealous of Joseph. One time the father sent him to take food to the brothers kwenye walikuwa wanachunga. Please continue looking at your neighbor because they cannot miss this. Ukiona neighbor amefunga macho kwa more than 2 minutes, ujue huyo kuna kuvuka anavuka. So unamwambia, sikia, story ya Joseph. Yes, very good. Yes, mama nani, mwambia sikia story ya Joseph. So they say, look, the dreamer is coming. Akafika. Lakini before afike, wakamfanyia kikitu hapo, wakasema tumuue. But Judah, and there is a deeper meaning on that. Judah said, no, we cannot kill him. He's our brother. Simeon akasema, I second. Levi akasema, I third. Gad akasema I fourth. Asha the fifth. Wote wakasema hatumui, tunamrusha kwa shimo. Wakashika, wakarusha kwa shimo. Thank God, because that pit did not have water. Ilikuwa empty. Although aligonga gongo huku mbavu na huku, lakini yakaland na hakuvunjika. Lakini wakasema situmwache huko. But they said no. These guys were kano. Ushaisikia kano. Walikuwa pesa ilikuwa na inawaribu kichwa. Wakasema, see, the Ishmaelites, they are passing. Situmuze. Wakasema, tumuze huyu. Alafu ya pesa tufanya nini? Tugawane. Na wakamuza, the guy when he went to Egypt, the Bible says after many years, the brothers went to Egypt to buy what? Grain, because of the famine. And guess who was in command? Ask your neighbor, guess who was in command? Amekwambia nani? Yusufu, he was in command. And the Bible says, when he saw them, he recognized them. But they did not recognize him. Yeye aliwajua kutoka mbali. Anasema, ule ni Simeon. Kwani alichapa aje? Akaangalia Juda. Hey, Juda kwani nywele ilienda wapi? And that is my vision. I know those guys walikuwa wamebeat. Bwana asifiwe. And Joseph alikuwa transformed by the glory of God. Pia hawakufanya nini? Hawakumjua. Hey, akasema, these are my brothers. Santa wafanya nini? You guys know the whole story. The summary of this story is, wakati sasa alikuja akawaambia yeye ni nani. Wote wakafanya nini? Wakainama. Wakasema, hey, ni kama oga. Inasema ngo ile aje ya huko? Igwe. Yes. Nani huwa mesema yu igwe? ni nani? Ni Karis. Wewe ni mesema igwe? Wakasema, igwe. Kumbe, this is our brother. The words that really makes my heart to beat so fast. Alisema, what you guys planned for evil, God turned it for good. I have nothing against you. Even if I have the power to kill all of you, but I have nothing against you. So the guy, the time he was in prison, the time he was in, you know, incriminated, ya kwamba alikuwa amelala na bibi ya Potifa, iyo ilikuwa process of becoming a son. You cannot become a son if you are dealing with unforgiveness. You cannot. Mungu anasema, huyu bado iko shida. Na naomba ati nimpatie 1 million. Watu kwa neighbor hakutakalika. Hakutakalika. So Joseph was given power. Because imagine, Farao alisema, between me and you, hakuna mwenye hapo katikati. Mimi nikitoka nienda US, you are the president of this country. He took a signet ring ya king, akamweka. Akasema, wherever you shall go, wewe ni Farao. And these guys know now all the power belongs to me. He sees the brothers and he says, I cannot harm you. Even though you guys were intending to kill me, and now I have the power. Hata niseme, unakatwa kidole leo, kwanza unapewa ugali. Ili usikie uchungu. But he says, I cannot do that. Because Joseph had now become a son. And that is what we are saying. God saw this one can handle power. He can handle being the second in command in Egypt. Na kampatia yo. So there is a process that a son has God's character. Bwana asifiwe. A son must carry God's character in them. Ya kwamba ile nature ya Mungu iwe ndani yako. Ili wakati Mungu anasema, now I am able to give you this, you cannot misuse this. Bwana asifiwe. We have also seen people in the Bible ambao walipata kitu na hawakuwa machua, wakaribu. And the story that I've just given, ya prodigal son, it's a very good example. Mungu amekufungulia njia, umepata 1 million. Sasa wewe kanisa huwezi kuja. Unakuja aje kanisa ukiwa na 1 million in your bank account? Mungu anaangalia akasema, okay, uko na business deals on Sunday, unapiga mamikutano Sunday. Mimi nilikupatia nikijua wewe uko son. On Sunday utakuwa kwangu, kwa nyumba yangu, ukinililia, ukiniita, ukinitukuza. Nimekuwekea tu only 1 million. Sunday unaambia mchungaji, I have a business meeting. Ninakuenda huko Villa Rosa Kempinski. Ati unajua nilikuwa na meet na my area MP. Ha! You are area MP. Na Mungu ndio alimake sure umepata only 1 million. Hiyo ni kama a drop in an ocean. Hey, Mungu anasema, Gabriel, ilikuwa cheki ya ngapi? 10 million. Patia huyu. Hiyo suri inaisha. Because maturity to handle what God has given you, it's not in you. when we come to you know, small things like faithfulness and generosity, kupeana tu wewe kwako ni shida. How do you do that? The Bible says, why do we love? Why do we love? Because he first. So when we come mambo ya kupendana, loving one another, it has no principle. Either he's your enemy, either she's your witch, whatever. The love has no boundary. Because you are actually paying a debt. When you are still sinners, the Bible says that Jesus still died for us. Alafu seme, hey, uyu mimi siwezi mpenda. Immaturity. Tell your neighbor, immaturity. That is it. You are struggling with love. Ati una struggle na kupenda neighbor hapo, kidogo kidogo. Ah, Mungu anasema hapa. Let me continue walking. They are still my child. Let us remember this. Na nilisema hivi. Na Biblia ituambia. Sisi wote ni wana wa? Na hiyo ni period. Mungu hata wa yitoa ati we toka. You will still remain to be a God's child. But when it comes to privileges and rights and possession, hapo wiko shida. You'll see there is a difference. Kwa sababu huyu nikimpatia, naona roho yake ni safi. You can imagine a whole Joseph mwenye ni second in command, na bitterness na anger iko ndani ya moyo wake. Our brother wangeona moto. Wangeona moto. Because he had now the power to do whatever he wanted. And that's why some of us, even when the world, Mungu wa anatupima na vitu kidogo. Kidogo sana. Aone how mature are we. And this maturity is all round. Ati unasikia mtu amegossip about you, amesema kitu ambayo wewe haukufanya. Na unajua haukufanya, lakini unasema huko sitawahi rudi. Immaturity. You understand? Yes, immaturity because you have a problem with, you know, dealing with men and with people. Let us now enter something. What maturity entails. How do you know someone can walk with maturity? And I'm still cautious with time. How and what maturity entails. Number one. When you get to up on number one. Mature sons are led by the Spirit. Mature sons are led by the Spirit. We open Romans chapter 8. Because that scripture iko hapo. Romans chapter 8 and verse 14. All right? Romans 8, verse 14. All of us, the Bible says, for all who are led by the Spirit, hey, as many are led by the Spirit of God, these are sons. You guys, can you understand the language? Yes, the language have changed from children now to sons. Na imesema ya kwamba, all that are led by this, and by the way, I might mention sons a lot. Remember daughter iko hapo ndani. Sawa sawa? Yes, yes, let us agree even daughter iko hapo ndani ya son. So inasema ya kwamba, as many as led by the Spirit of God, these people are called sons. They are no longer now called children. Watoto ndio wanaongozwa na my emotion, na my moods, na my feelings. But children, sons of God are now led by the Spirit. Because if, for example, umesikia jambo and then umeanza kureact, hizo ni mamoods. The Holy Spirit has not led you. But the Bible have told us that real sons of God are always led by the Spirit. Eh, they are not led by emotions. They are not led by, you know, moods. Ati nimeamka na mood gani? Unajinyosha hivi unasema, hii ni mood ya kutoenda church. Movie, pub, ama kuenda. No, we are led by the Spirit. And when we are now, we continue being led by the Spirit. Now God says, now this one can handle some things that I want to give. Because Abu hawajiongozi. And that's why the Bible says in the book of Proverbs, I lean not on my own understanding. Sons do not lean on their own understanding. No, sons will always inquire of God. What do you want me to do? And we saw Jesus as the Son of God. Jesus, by the way, for your information, have you read anywhere in the Bible? The Bible says Jesus is a child of God. Ushaisoma mali on an individual level. Ati Yesu alikuwa child. No, the Bible says Son of God. Because he came bearing fullness of a son to come and deal. the business of the Father. So Yesu alitumwa dunia, akaambiwa enda, you transact business for me. So when your son is mature enough, utamwambia enda ile mkutano. Aende mkutano acha. Hey, by the way, for your information, my father here ananitumanga naenda mikutano. The other day I was in Strathmore University kupiga mikutano ya mabazu huko. Because he knows my son will do ABCD. So God says, this one is mature enough. Go, enda upige ile deal, na nikama mimi. Wewe nikama mimi, because now you have become a son. Hallelujah. So we understand that all this concept, what the Bible is telling us, ya kwamba, your capacity, you have now become a son. You are able to represent God. Ask your neighbor, are you able to represent God? Mungu amekutuma mahali, you know God is merciful. You know God, akona, God akutuna character yake. Do you show that character? Ama ukitumwa mikutano ni kupiga kelele huko, hata ukai chini, unaulizwa, walisema, by the way, kuna wale wazazi wanatumanga watoto wao, waende mikutano ya shule. Ziki kama nowadays huwa ina happen, kitambo ilikuwa ina happen. Mzazi anaona ati my son, amekuwa enough. Kuna mkutano imeitwa ya inaitwa PTA, parents and teacher. Sisemi nasema umeitwa uende PTA kwa shule. Inaitwa PTA, parents association. Hakuna PTA Karisi. Wewe ushaigua kwa board. Now you, when you go there, mzazi wako amekutuma na urudishe report. Kuna watu ukienda mkutano umetumwa na mzazi wako. Instead ya kukaa kwa mkutano na utake notes, wewe ulikuwa tu una chat. Wewe ni masimu. The report that you needed to take back to your father. Anakuambia, "Hey, mkutano ilikuwa aje?" Ah, hiyo mkutano haikuwa kitu. Hakuna. Kwanza hiyo principal hata sijui chenye alikuwa anasema. How do you tell your father ati hata ujui venye principal alikuwa anasema? And your father sent you to go represent him in listening to those meetings. So Mungu anakuangalia anasema, huyu zile report ataniletea, huyu siwezi tuma. Wewe kaa tu huku nyumbani, enda ukachunge mambuzi na huku, wewe fanya kazi ya nyumbani. Because you cannot transact business for the father. And that's why we say that a child has God's nature, but a son has God's character. Anabeba character ya baba yake. Hata akishow kwa meeting, amepiga luku. Unajua luku? Uliza neighbor, unajua luku ni nini? Hebu muulize kama unajua luku. Luku ni gani? Luku anaingia mkutano akiwa sharp. Hawasemi this is a hard boy. Hawasemi atakuwa ni huyu ni kijana wa kuchunga mbuzi. No, umepiga luku kama budako. Hata respect soldier, hawa soldier wa gate pale. Sometimes anaendaga mahala, aha, ni aje bazu. Yes sir. Kwa sababu ya luku. Wanazifiwe. Because you are carrying the character of God. Yes, you carry the character of God. So hata ukisema niko na point. Mwenye alikuwa anachea atasema nani huyo anapiga kelele hapo nyuma? Because you have the character of God. Hallelujah. So these sons of God are led by the Spirit. They are not led by the body emotions and feelings. No. They are led by the Holy Ghost. When they want to do something, they inquire. We want to enter into the book of Galatians as we excavate this, because we are almost trying to wind up this. Galatians 5 from verse 17 and 18. This is what the Bible says, because tuko hapo kwa hiyo story, they are not led by the flesh. Biblia inasema, the old sinful nature loves to do evil, which is just opposite from what the Spirit wants. The Bible says, and the Spirit gives us desires that are opposite from what the sinful nature desires. So these two forces are constantly fighting each other. Galatians, Wagalatia 5:17. Inasema, these two forces are constantly fighting each other. And your choices are never free from this conflict. I like verse 18. Because it says, but if you are led by the Holy Spirit, say, if I am led by the Spirit, I am not under the law. So God wants us to get to a level. Ya kwamba, you are not led by your emotions and feelings and your flesh. No. When your flesh tells you, ati mimi nataka, mwili yako inakwambia nataka ABCD, unayambia listen, shut up, shut up. No. You are now able to command the flesh. Because now you are a grown-up son. You are not operating by the body. You are not operating by the appetites. No, you are the bodily appetites. Appetites are mwili. You are not giving yield to that. No, you are saying, no, I cannot do this. Because you are now a mature son. So the Bible have told us the old sinful nature, it loves to do what is evil. Ile nature ya kitambo ambayo ni ilikufa, inataka kufanya mambo. By the way, for your information, wakati uliokoka, kuna kitu iliokoka ndani yako. And the Bible says you are born again in spirit. But your flesh and your body remained with you. Let us agree. Moses uliokoka lakini mwili yako ilibaki na wewe. Na mwili yako haikuokoka. So, how you become a son is when you get the wisdom to tell the flesh, shut up, and tell the spirit, lead. That is now the dissection where you become a son. Because wakati uliokoka, mwili yako ilibaki tu ikuwa hapo. Kama ulikuwa unapiga kanusu polepole, uliacha. Lakini, kuna hiyo desire. Desire bado iko. But when you tell the desire, no, you cannot do this. Sasa, now God say, now I can deal with this. But anytime desire inakuja, unajipata umerudi. Sasa, yes, you are still saved. And that is 100% sure. And I'm going back to that information. When you are born again, in the morning when we are praying here, Jude 1:24. Ilikuwa inasema, he is able to keep you from stumbling and falling and to present you glorious in his presence without sin. The Bible says that. So when you become a child, you will forever become a child. Lakini now the graces to acquire and to get to point where God wants you to get, it needs maturity. And one of the way you become a mature son is being led by the Spirit. Hallelujah. Say one way to become a son is being led by the Holy Spirit. Hey, wakati labda kuna shida hapo kidogo nyumbani, amsikizani kidogo hapo na bwana yako, you know, let the Spirit to lead you. Hallelujah. That is how God says, ah, this is not mature enough. And there is this story in the book of, this person was called Naomi. Not Naomi, Hannah. Hannah was barren. Na alikuwa anaomba sana Mungu ampe mtoto. Na alikuwa na bibia. Huyo bibi mwingine wa bwana yake alikuwa anaitwa nani? Penina. Biblia inasema Penina alikuwa anamdhihaki. But God saw the maturity of this daughter. Instead of wanasimama pale nje na Penina wanaanza kujibizana ama kama wamama wa ploti. You guys, do you live in plot 10? Ambao unapata plot 10 wamama wanapigania kamba. How can a daughter of God anapigania kamba na mwanamke mwingine? How? Mungu anasema huyo hataziwezi mbe plot yake. Siwezi. Because how do you quarrel? Wewe kwanza sema umeokoka na kitamba. Ati nani alianika kamba unazitoa unaziangusha? Hai. God looks at you and says, what is the problem with this woman? Because you are not mature enough. Bwana asifiwe. Ukipata wameanika nguo hapo, si ununue hata sasa mwambia, ah, mimi hata sina shida. Itafuata ke? Kwani hizo nguo zote ndio ulikuwa unavaa kesho? Sometimes we need the wisdom of God. Bwana asifiwe. So that when now God sees you, now he wants to use you in his business, he say, this one, I can. Number two, there is something we call sons are knowledgeable. Sons work on a knowledge. They don't operate with ignorance. Andika hiyo, that is number two. What entails mature son ni kwamba, one of the character ni kwamba, sons are knowledgeable, work on a knowledge. They don't operate with ignorance. No, they have data. Work on a knowledge flani wamekua nayo. And the Bible says, in the book of Proverbs, because kuna kitu mzuri sana hapo. Let us open in Proverbs chapter 3. Just from verse 1, you hear the language. And I would want you to read with either KJV, do not read NLT, because NLT haifanyi translation mzuri. NKJV, NIV, AMP, NKJV zinafanya very good. Inasema, my son, all of us, my son, do not forget my laws, but let your heart keep my commandments. So the Bible does not say my child. It is say who? And it is say who? My son. Because instructions are not given to children. No. Instructions are given to sons. And that's why on Sunday, Mchungaji alikuwa anatuambia, our God is a God of instructions. So instructions are not given to a child. No. They will not follow. But instructions are given to sons who are mature enough to know, na niliambiwa ABCD, so I need to do ABCD. Hallelujah. So it says, my son, do not forget my law, but let your heart keep my commands. Why? For they will give you a long and satisfying life. So the Bible gives us this son, ambaye amepewa instruction. When they observe the laws of the Lord, they are able now to live a fulfilled life. Because God is dealing with a son who is mature. By the way, this proverb was written by a man we know. He's called Solomon. And Solomon, he had written several books. One book of Solomon is, sasa nimesema hii proverb. Another one he wrote, Songs of Solomon. Another one he wrote, Ecclesiastes. Now, this is the order. This is how the Bible was written. Na aliandika hivi. Ya kwanza akiwa mchanga, wakati tu alikalia kiti, aliandika Songs of Solomon. This guy was in love. This guy, he was young. He was maybe my age. And that's why he wrote the book of Songs of Solomon. And there is a lot of love that is revolving around the Songs of Solomon. Wakati alitoka hapo, akakuja sasa, akaingia level ya middle age. Akakuja sasa kwa proverb. Akazaa watoto, akaanza. What's going on? So wakati alipata watoto, Mungu akampatia information ya kuandika proverbs. That's why a father was addressing sons. He had sons. So he was addressing sons. And sasa in his old age, Mungu akampatia revelation, andike the book of Ecclesiastes. This is where you find a scripture that says, all is vanity. It's like chasing the wind. When you have wealth, it's like chasing the wind. Na akaandika chapter 12 of Ecclesiastes. Akasema, the youth, do whatever you want. But know this. You understand? Gen Z. Akakuja akayadress hapo. Akasema, youth, Gen Z, do whatever you want. But know that there is judgment. Whatever you do, there is judgment. So he was writing as a man who is now full of wisdom. That was oozing from his body. So he says back to our engagement, he's now addressing sons. And I say, my son, not my child no more. Because sons carry instructions of God. Watoto, ata mama B, my mom, you know very well. Akina Ruth, na nani, hawezi ati wambe instruction. Ambie, muone katun, nitakuja. Lakini muash, no mambia, enda pale. You see, kuna difference. Because even comprehension is very different. So if you are a child, na Mungu anakupatia instruction, anaona umefanya vituko, anasema huyu bado ni mtoto. Let me give them time to fanya nini? To grow. But sons operate with knowledge. They operate with information. Ambayo Mungu amesema, do not do this. Kama anakuambia, forgive one another. Na wewe, hiyo instruction, zenye tuliongea pana mchungaji, you don't follow those instructions. Anaona, hii ni kutupa. Huyu hata sasa nikishinda kumuombia, waja nimpe time kidogo afanya nini? Akue. Alafu ukikua, ukifika kiwango fulani, now God can tell you, enda pale ufanya hivi, unaenda unafanya, anasema, okay. Now we can agree. So sons operate under instructions. And sons operate under knowledge. Verse 3 inasema, never let loyalty and kindness away from you. So imagine hapa, honesty, kuongea ukweli. Wewe umeshindwa kuongea nini? Ukweli. Kwa kitu kidogo, Mungu anasema iko shida hapa. Huyu kama uongo tu ndio inamsumbua. Huyu sasa siwezi dealing yangu na yeye, lazima ikae kwanza kando kidogo. So anasema never let loyalty and truthfulness and kindness get away from you. That is verse 3. wear them like a necklace. Vaa hizi vitu kama mkufu ama mshanga. Mkufu. Naitwa mkufu. Ambia neighbor, necklace inaitwa mkufu. Mwambie necklace inaitwa mkufu. Nasema mtukufu. Inaitwa mkufu. So anasema wear them like a necklace. Write them deep within your heart. So God's instruction on sons are not written on books. No, they are written on people's hearts. I thank God because of that message that our God is a God of instruction. Mungu amekupatia instruction so that you can mature to become a son. Eh, nakwambia do this and this. So inasema ya kwamba write them deep within your heart. Verse 4, inasema ya kwamba then you will find favor with both God and people and you will gain a good reputation. When you observe these laws of God, it says you will find favor with both God and people and you will gain good reputation. Abba Jini nasema now, do not lean on your own understanding, but in all your ways, acknowledge Him and He will establish. So, instructions are given to sons. And when you follow their instructions, you find that you are able to fulfill what God has given you. So, every Sunday wakati tunakujanga kanisa, mchungaji anatuhubiria, hizo ni instruction huwa tunapewa. Ili tukue nini? Sons. Because, by the way, God is not happy when you remain a child forever. Let me just use my father there. Abi. Abi, how old are you? 18 years. 19. When is your birthday? When is your birthday? June 11. Okay, June 11. Oh, now you. My mom, Connie, what happened? I'm going to see that kidogo. So, imagine Abi ameishi kukua kama Ruth. How? Ati, you say you are 19. Na unafanya vitu za Ruth. See, you will be worried. Ulishindwa mtu huyu shida yake ni gani? Because they are not growing. Ati anashinda class 3. Ati uko wapi? 19 years. Niko class. How do you become uko 19 na bado uko class 3? Aji. How? So God is not happy when we remain in one place. No. That's why every Sunday anakwambia enda kanisa ufunzwe. Every day anakwambia chukua Biblia usome. Ukishika chenye umesoma hapa uingize hapa kwa kichwa. Now you will grow and go to the next level. Hallelujah. Because God does not want us to stay stagnant. God wants us to grow. Hallelujah. God wants us to have many things. Now remember Matthew ambayo tulisoma chapter 7 verse 12. Ilisema kama baba za huku duniani wanapea zile vitu mzuri mzuri. How much more does our father, not our God, listen to the story, our father wants to give you. So it is the will of our father to give us so many things. But what is the capacity? Capacity ya kuhandle. Unajua una employee hapa kidogo, umepata kazi hapa, una deal na pesa. Wewe unachukua pesa yote unafanya nini? Una gambo. Father says, kwa ni nani nilipea hii kazi? Anasema there is no way. Because capacity ya kuhandle hii pesa. Hana. Anasema sasa, tufanya hivi, ilikuwa ngapi? Ilikuwa 100,000, rudisha 10. Hii mchungaji ametubiri hapa. Rudisha wapi? Hii sasa ndiyo haita musumbua. Ngoja agrow yo. Because we have to embrace the process of growth. And some of us, unfortunate, they stay like that forever. Mtu anasema niliokoka 40 years ago. Lakini ebu jiangalie, wewe mwenyewe, aki, ebu jiangalie. 40 years, 30 years, 20 years, nizile, ni vitu gani ulikuwa, unakuwa nazo huko, na bado sayuko nazo. God is not happy. He wants you to grow. And that is why every Sunday, every now and then he speaks to your heart. Anakuambia, my son, listen to my instruction. Grow. Do better. You can do better than this. Advance in stature. The Bible says in the book of Luke, and Jesus was born and he continued advancing both in wisdom and in stature and he gained favor with men and also with God. Yes, wakati alizaliwa ali advance growth. You are now able to be given a responsibility. Unatumwa mkutano, unaenda una represent na unalete good report. But kama wewe ulitumwa, unashinda na masimu, hata ulienda raundi muenda, ukarudi wakiomba, haujui chenye walisema. You cannot be entrusted. And that is now where the Christian life is actually coined. The process of growing na kuhandle. Maybe you are praying, I want this and this. Lakini Mungu akikuangalia, this has nothing to do with the youth. Bwana, Mungu naomba, bwana ama bibi. Unasema bibi si mbaya, hata bwana hapana mbaya, lakini he place. Kwa nini hapa iko hivi? God anaona, I cannot entrust you to someone's girl ama son because iko shida wapi? Mahali. So growth is very key. And it actually applies to every sector of our lives. Our last scripture is 1 Corinthians. This is our last scripture. Wakorintho wa kwanza, 13:11. Wakorintho wa kwanza, 13:11. Now, all of us, it is like this. When I was a child... When I read that scripture, nasikiaga kitu ikiamka kwa moyo. When I was a child, I spoke and thought like a child. I reasoned as a child. I walked as a child. But when I grew up, nikaacha vitu za kitoto. That's what the Bible says. Wakati nilikuwa mtoto, nilikuwa nafanya mambo ya ufala. Lakini wakati nilikuwa, nikaacha mambo ya utoto. Nikaanza kufanya mambo ya mtu mzima. So God is calling us to a process ya kufanya mambo ya watu wazima. People who are mature, even their talk, kuongea kwao, kuna maturity. Do not allow yourself to talk like a child. No, do not. Do not allow yourself ati shetani aliniingia. Ali kuingililia wapi and you are a son. Shetani by the way anaingiliaga watoto. You guys have babies. Munaona venya watoto huwa wana act. I like kale katoto ka sister yangu. Kakimkasirisha, kachukuliwe. And I've observed it. Naonanga kanapelekwa ile base. Kakishikwa anaanza, pole mom, kwa sababu kanajua. Kakiingizwa ile base. What is going to happen? So she's thinking like a child. Sasa wewe, unakosea Mungu anaanza kumwambia pole Mungu. Mungu anasema, "Huu ni mslapa ama nifanye nini? Toka hapa." Because you are acting as a child. Like in the Bible says, when you are a child, know that you have become a son. Do things that actually shows that you are a son. And asema, I will put away childish things. Kwani ya Kikuyu inasema nini? Nani akona ya Kikuyu? Because this is our last scripture. Mtu tu atusomee ya Kikuyu. Baba Ben, ya kona ya Kikuyu? Ala, kwani hakuna mtu akona ya Kikuyu? Baba Mombi, Mama Mombi. Baba Mombi ndio anatusomeanga. Mama Mombi yako ni ya? Ni ya Kikuyu? Is it? Mombi, is it for Kikuyu? Bring it. Yes, bring the Bible. Musikie mambo. Lete your Bible. Lete musikie maneno. Apelekea Baba Ben. Apelekea Baba Ben. Aizome tusikie vile inasema. Hii ni ya Kikuyu ndio tunamaliza nayo.
13:11. Oh, 13:13. Rĩrĩa ndarĩ kana-rĩ, ndaragia ta kana. Mũiguĩre wakwa wa ũhoro naguo warĩ o wa kana. Ona. Ona gũtarania da utaranagia ta kana no rĩu ndanatuĩka mũndũ mũgima-rĩ nĩndĩkĩtie gũte maũndũ ma wana.
Niliacha mambo ya nini? Utoto. Nasema, I did away wana, nikawacha, kando kabisa. So, when you grow up in God, and we know that the Bible says that we are now led by the Spirit. The things of childish behavior, I left them. Because there is a level you cannot deal with God when you are still a child. It's okay. And we agreed. Sisi wote ni watoto wa Mungu. Na wakipelekwa, watoto wote, baba abia kisema, tunapeleka Garden City, pale KFC, kupiga kuku. Sina wapeleka wote. Either they are mature or not. Wanaenda kukula kuku. Lakini wakikula kuku, unachukua the sun. Unambia, by the way, kuna shamba niko nayo mahali. So God is able to take us to KFC, tunakula. But secrets, secrets of the wealth of the Father, they're only given to sons. Bwana asifiwe. I know there is a place Glenn will get with his father. Ambiwe, niko na account ingine sijai kuonyesha. Ndiyo hii. Na hii ndiyo password. Lakini saa hii, kuna kitu hawezi fanya nini? Ata withdraw, aende Malaysia. Hallelujah. Glenn, you are a good guy and I love you. And you are a good son. But I'm telling you, hawezi muonyesha. Umuonyesha account. Kesho utaamuka upate. Imeoshwa yote. Because hakuna ile nini? Capacity. But kuna mwingine hata ukimpatia account na password na pin. Hata uwezi fikiria pesa yako itaenda mahali. Because now he's reasoning as a father. He has the character of a father. And that's why we said a son carries the character of a father. They don't misrepresent the father. They walk, they talk, they conduct, they think, they respond, they understand like a father. Bwana asifiwe. So it is by the grace of God that we pray. Wewe mwenye unajijua. Hata sitasema msimame. Wewe you know yourself. And the area. Wewe unajua ni area gani unafanya mambo ya kitoto. It's not, mimi situsi mutu. It's the Bible. Kuna mambo unafanya ya nini? Ya kitoto. Please pray. Tell the Holy Spirit. Hii kitu Mungu mistaki. I want to become a son. So that I can inherit. Remember what the Bible said. As long as the child is still young. Mali yake yote ni kama iko kwa api? Kwa slave. Because they have no capacity to handle what God has already given them. So brothers and sisters in Christ, there is a lot that God has prepared for us. Mambo mzuri, mambo kubwa. Lakini, the capacity. We want to pray for capacity. And let's have the key, Bonnie. Because you just have a good time with God. Mwambia tu ile level we unajua, umekua tu ki struggle. You need to become a full son. You need to be led by the Holy Spirit. You need to have the knowledge of the Holy Spirit so that you are able to grow. You are able to do things like God himself, to have the character of God so that you are able to be taught by God himself in the name of Jesus. Father, we bless you because you are faithful. You alone is our God. You have never failed, Elohim. You alone will never fail. And because you have spoken to us through your word, the Lord, there is a process of becoming a son. We pray that you help me to take away anything that is not from you, Jesus. I pray that my heart is going to be aligned by you, my Father. Guide me by your presence. Lead me in your path. I pray that you help me, my Father, to grow in areas that are retarded and stagnant. In the mighty name of Jesus, Lord, I pray that your divine grace will operate within me, God. I pray that now that I am a grown-up, in the things of the Spirit, I operate as a son. In the mighty name of Jesus, that I may be able to inherit everything that you have accorded under my name. My Lord and my Father, guide me, make me grow, make me to advance, make me to enter into levels of dealings in the mighty name of Jesus. Levels of humility, levels of love, levels of generosity in the mighty name of Jesus. Lamoza kanda elibozaya raposa kitiliosa mantele buzika ranande bozia rima kantele buzaya rima zakanda remuzikaya endele sola ribosikatia mandele soliada endele buzika yandele buziana. If you know. Bwana wetu na baba yetu, tunajongea mbele zako adhuhuli ya leo Bwana. Tukisema ni asanti kwa maana wewe ni mwaminifu. Umetufunza neno lako Bwana, that there is a process of becoming sons. And you who analyzes the hearts of men, analyze our hearts in accordance with your thy kindness. And Father, take away anything that is not from you. My Father, some of us has been struggling with unforgiveness. Some of us have been struggling with anger. Some of us have been struggling with pride. Some of us has been struggling with not being faithful. Lord Almighty, we ask you, with all humility, O God, search through our hearts and our mind. And Father, take away anything that does not show that we are your sons. For we yearn and we desire to be your sons, not just your children. In the mighty name of Jesus, help us to hear your instructions. Help us to be led by your spirit. May you deposit your knowledge and your wisdom in our systems, that we are able to do your will, O God. In the mighty name of Jesus. Father, you have reminded us that a son has your character. A son bears your image. Father, we pray that we may carry your character. You have also taught us that a son is taught by you. May we be taught by the Holy Ghost. In the mighty name of Jesus. Help us to grow and enter into levels. Levels that we shall access all your blessing. And because we are operating under open heaven, I have seen open the doors of access. We shall have the capacity to handle every blessing that you have given us. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.